Thank you for joining us. I'm Jacqueline Davies with Zions Direct, and I'm here today with Chip Loughridge, Vice President for Zions Bank Capital Markets. This video is a continuation of our series giving individuals who have some familiarity with fixed income securities a little more understanding about municipal bonds. And we're talking today about the fundamentals of creating bond ladders. Chip, thank you so much for joining us today.
Jackie, it's a pleasure to be here.
What is a bond ladder?
Well, by definition, a bond ladder is a portfolio of bonds with a number of different maturities. The goal of a bond ladder basically is to provide a predictable income with interest rate risk reduction and liquidity.
What types of principles should we be looking for, or guidance should we be looking for in these different maturities? What types of securities will go into these?
Basically, Jackie, any security can go into a bond ladder that's a fixed income or a steady cash flow item. The most common structure of a bond ladder is with treasury bonds or tax-exempt municipal bonds, corporate bonds, CDs, and so anything just basically fits into a structure of a portfolio of a bond ladder nature.
How do we get started?
Well, that's a good question. Getting started in anything is tough. Mm-hmm. But basically, I think you need to ask yourself some basic questions. What are my future cash flow needs? What are my big plans 5 years out from now, 10 years out from now, 20 years from now? Is college on the horizon? Is a new car on the horizon, a new house, things like that? Am I going to need cash flow for other circumstances? So that would help you to determine what your weighting would be. A lot of cash flow, weight the front end. Not immediate needs, more toward the middle or the longer end for your highest income.
What can we think about in terms of liquidity? Because I know that that is on a lot of people's mind, is, you know, what if I need the cash now?
Well, that's a big concern these days, obviously. Mm-hmm. But that's primarily addressed with the structure of a bond ladder is a series of different maturities, each successively longer. As the shorter maturities come due, turn into cash, you have the option at that time of using that cash for cash flow, other liquidity purposes, or reaching out to however long you would like to reach maturity-wise for some additional yield or the largest yield, which would be available on the longest maturities. So the idea is as the longer maturities come closer and closer as time extends, then those become your liquidity maturities, each laddering out or use the money for liquidity.
Considering the current economic conditions in the world situation the way it is today, are you seeing a different trend in the way people are structuring these bond ladders?
Well, the tendency would be to address the immediate concern ahead of you. Mm-hmm. The interesting thing is, though, every 4 years, you're guaranteed to have a different environment. So a bond ladder addresses that just by its mere structure. If you start with short maturities for liquidity, intermediate maturities for future liquidity, and more of a yield component on there, and then longer maturities for your maximum yield, less liquidity, I think you've addressed just about any kind of change in the economic environment that we would foresee. Currently, we are at the lowest interest rates we've experienced in many, many a year. It doesn't, however, preclude from reaching for some yield. So.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Chip. It's been so nice to speak with you.
Well, Jackie, thank you for having me here.
Today, we've been talking with Chip Loughridge about bond ladder fundamentals, and we'll hope to see you again next time.